Aladdin Creations.
Hello guys, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. Today in this short video I'm going to discuss with you one of important bacteriology topic, how to identify and confirm Staphylococcus saprobiticus bacteria in medical laboratory. We'll discuss in this short video. Hope you all know about Staphylococcus aureus. This Staphylococcus saprobiticus is also belong to the same Staphylococcus species, but there are few differences. Staphylococcus saprobiticus is one of skin commensal microbe. However, it is the second most common cause for urinary tract infection in female between the ages of 17 to 27. And also it is common causative organisms of cystitis in women due to occurrence as common vaginal flora. Usually it's sensitive to wide range of antibiotics but resist to drug novocaine. We can distinguish it from Staphylococcus epidermidis and other coagulase negative staphylococci due to it is resistant to novocaine. Let's see how to detect Staphylococcus saprobiticus in laboratory. First important one is to look at the growth pattern and colony morphology to have an idea about culture growth. When we consider the growth of blood agar, Staphylococcus saprobiticus give a wide, flat, non-hemolytic colonies. Small lactose fermented colonies are the result of growth of Meconcia agar. Then we can prepare for gram stain. Staphylococcus saprobiticus are gram positive cocci in clusters. Usually once we detect a particular organism as gram-positive cocci, what we need to do is the catalase test. Catalase test is positive for Staphylococci saprobiticus. Depending on all about diagnostic results and with the use of clinical history, we should have a direction to perform the next testing panel. If we suspect Staphylococcus species, then we can perform the coagulase test. For the Staphylococcus saprobiticus, it gives negative results. There are two common coagulase negative Staphylococcus species are clinically significant. They are Staphylococcus epidermidis and Staphylococcus saprobiticus. If we need further differentiation, we can perform novocaine sensitivity test and other sugar fermentation test. Staphylococcus saprobiticus is novocaine resistant while Staphylococcus epidermidis is sensitive. If we consider some of sugar fermentation results, it gives mannose negative, triose positive and mannitol negative result. Through this diagnostic test along with clinical suspicion, we can identify Staphylococcus saprobiticus in clinical laboratory setup. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and gain some knowledge about this Staphylococcus saprobiticus bacteria identification. Now you can find this video script from our website www.aladdincreations.com. So don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical laboratory science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.